to be or not to be. 7 months into the pandemic, live theaters are struggling to raise the curtain. John Yang is back to take us to one regional company in rural Virginia that hopes it has found a way for the show to go on safely. It's part of our ongoing American Creators series on rural arts and canvas, our coverage of arts and culture.
So will I turn her virtue into
theater audiences have gotten used to admonitions about silencing cell phones, but unusual times call for unusual requests.
We ask that you continue to wear your masks and wear them properly. If you do not wear them properly, we will kill you. If this pandemic doesn't.
At the American Shakespeare Center, nestled in Virginia's Shenandoah Valley, a rare sight. Live theater, indoors, with a live audience. Alternating performances of Othello and Twelfth Night through October 18th.
Some of the very large organizations, I think they can afford to kind of run for the hills, wait for the wave to break, and then come back and reopen.
Artistic director Ethan McSweeney.
The small to mid-size like us, our solution was to surf the wave and hopefully stay afloat.
McSweeney led an appropriately distanced tour of the 32-year-old company's theater.
You don't expect this when you come into the small town of Stanton, Virginia, and you walk into our sort of unprepossessing, rather ordinary lobby, and then you're in here in this incredible world's only recreation of Shakespeare's indoor theater, the Blackfriars Playhouse.
Like Shakespeare's 17th century Blackfriars, there is minimal scenery, no sound amplification, and universal lighting illuminating both audience and actors. But unlike the Bard's Theater, even though it operated at the time of the bubonic plague, there are elaborate safety precautions.
We started creating a series of protocols that we ended up calling Safe Start. We started with the workplace protocols and also added the audience protocols, many of which are the same and similar, but it was, I mean, obviously, as the name suggests, safety is the primary.
It was a wonderful first day of rehearsal.
For the actors, the plan, developed with medical advice, had an initial two-week quarantine with rehearsals over Zoom. Next came in-person rehearsals, first with masks and then gradually without. Backstage personnel and management still must wear masks at all times.
The Count himself here hard by wood.
To let patrons choose the way they're most comfortable seeing a show, for the first time the company added outdoor performances on the grounds of the nearby Blackburn Inn and streamed performances on the internet. Othello is set in Venice at the time of the plague, so some scenes incorporate masks. Infection rates are relatively low in the area, and the company has not had any COVID cases. The performers have daily symptom checks, live in their own bubble in company-provided housing, and have signed an isolation covenant. Jessica D. Williams plays the title role in Othello.
You know, this is not risk-free. It's like we've tightened it up, and I think we've done a great job, and we've all taken care of each other, and it's been working so far.
John Harrell is in his 26th season with the theater.
I think we all know at this point the entire enterprise depends on our being responsible to a larger group. But that is a condition that ensemble actors are used to, whether it's COVID or other things. We all know, you know, actors are always on time and we always know our lines.
From the stage, cast members keep an eye on whether audiences obey the requirement to keep their masks on. They can stop a performance at any time.
It's a certain level of anxiety. It's like, well, is she just taking a deep breath and going to put it right back on? Do I need to stop the show? What do I do? Do I alert the stage management? It's just one more thing to be paying attention to and to be juggling. But so far we haven't had, everybody's been really compliant with our rules.
Seating capacity in the indoor theater has been cut by more than 50%. And the mask requirement for audiences has meant some adjustment for actors.
You're used to looking, is that person smiling? Is that person on the verge of laughing at this joke? Do they look angry? Do they look bored? All of those cues that we take, I've started noticing that you can see those cues anyway. It's just a little bit, you have to just pay a little bit more attention. So it was odd at first, but like with everything else in this pandemic, it's gotten easier and more, you just get more used to it.
Audience members at a recent indoor matinee of Othello said they felt safe. Azriana Prilo and Kara Painter came from nearby Harrisonburg, Virginia.
I mean, we were more than 6 feet away from the closest person.
Yeah.
And so knowing that and seeing that makes it feel like they're doing all that they can.
Yeah, and theater is probably about one of the oldest forms of art, storytelling. So like bringing it back outside or bringing it inside, it's still just the same core of telling a story, telling people's points of view and kind of learning and growing with other people.
Laura Latimer and Shobhit Gupta traveled from Charlottesville, Virginia.
Well, I wish I weren't wearing a mask, but I think they made a good show of it, you know, kind of they even wore their masks on stage, as you saw at some point. So I think, you know, recognizing the times is very Shakespeare too, right? He's, you know, recognized what was going on in the world and played up to that. So I think it was very fitting, I suppose.
Some said attending a live performance for the first time in nearly a year was surprisingly moving. Karen Marsh of Charlottesville.
I didn't realize how much I missed it when before the performance started and they came out singing, I started weeping. And it was completely unexpected to me, but it was so powerful just to be in the presence of creative people doing art. It really was moving.
The theater hopes it's found a way to provide more people with that experience during the pandemic, announcing that in December it will stage the holiday classic, A Christmas Carol. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm John Yang in Stanton, Virginia.
The Bard would be pleased. So wonderful that they are doing this in Stanton.